Today is Friday, February 23rd, and it's an F day.
Good luck to our AWK athletes this weekend as our wrestling and swimming teams compete in the DIAA state tournaments. Also, good luck to the freshman boys basketball team as they take on St. Elizabeth's High School at St. Mark's this Saturday at 7:50 p.m.
Let's not forget our mock trial team as they compete this weekend at the courthouse. Let's hear from the team.
Hi, everyone. So Parker and I are both defense attorneys on Archer's mock trial team. And this weekend, we're traveling to the Wilmington Courthouse to compete in the Delaware Mock Trial Competition. We'll be participating in four trials, trying to prove our case and competing in front of an actual judge and a panel of jury members.
That was my line, so yeah.
All right, so this year's case is about an art heist that occurred in 2016. My client, Elliot Stewart, has been arrested because she was accused of stealing paintings. Haley is actually the person that the defense is trying to pin this case on, and saying that she was actually the one to take possession of the paintings and wanted to sell them on the black market. So I'm crossing Haley in this. But yeah, it's an interesting case. It's about art. Ellie, anything else?
I'm Brooke Benjamin.
She's Brooke Benjamin, and I'm crossing her.
I'm a journalist, and I was arrested for stealing the stolen paintings, even though I didn't do it.
She did.
Fall of 2016, the defendant, Elliot Stewart, met with convicted art thief Miles Warren and told him she had found what she was looking for in her late father's storage shed. What she found? Valuable paintings of renowned artist Andrew Wyeth, stolen almost two decades earlier. And what she did next? Or, more importantly, what she didn't do in response to finding these paintings is what brings us here today. Good afternoon, Your Honor, members of the jury. My name is Patrick Walsh.
Don't forget the Be Positive Tournament registration is open until March 2nd. The Be Positive Club will also be hosting a Chipotle night at the Glen Mills Chipotle from 5 to 9 on Saturday, March 3rd. Remember to say you are with the Archmere Be Positive fundraiser. Don't forget to mark your calendars for the Be Positive Tournament on Saturday, March 10th from 4 to 8 p.m.
Make sure you come out and support our actresses and actors this weekend at the musical Pippin on both Friday and Saturday at 7:30. The preview was great this Tuesday. For next week's Saturday performance, if you bring your Chipotle receipt, you can receive $2 off your play ticket.
Oh my god, natural settings. Whoa. Are these stage crew members for Pippin?
Yes.
What's your favorite part about stage crewing for Pippin?
None of it.
This is joke of the week.
Joke of the week is this play.
Come see it. It's me, Pippin. What's your favorite part of Pippin?
Oh god, I don't really know. I like it when they, like, took off your sweater and you noticed your
shirt. Hey, Zach, what's your favorite part about being my son?
Oh, it's because it's you, Jack, obviously.
What's your favorite part of choreographing?
I really love... What I really love about choreographing is just working with all the students, seeing everybody's different abilities and talents, and just seeing how people get really excited when they learn something new and they get up on stage and have a really good time doing it. So,
who's the worst dancer?
Oh, nobody is a bad dancer.
Okay, it's me.
No, it's not Amy. No, and nobody's a bad dancer. Everyone is really, really good.
Okay. Hey, Emily. What's your favorite part about lighting for the musical?
It's not sound.
Well, you light up my world, Emily. Oh, okay. Hey, Grace.
Hello.
What's your favorite part about being a soldier?
War is a science.
Oh, yeah.
It's going crazy.
Yeah, she likes to kill people. What's your favorite part about Pippin?
I really like the people doing it because it's just really fun and I made a lot of friends during it.
I think it's the monk costume.
Yeah.
It's the monk costume.
Break a leg. Now it's time for Awk of the Week.
So hi, Mrs. Lobo. So
hi, Emily.
Who is our Awk of the Week this week?
I'd like to nominate Evan Hernick as Awk of the Week. He's really been Awk of the Year in my Algebra 2 class because he helps everybody with the Algebra 2 stuff. He actually loves what we're doing, which is awesome, because he'll see a topic and say, wow, I always wanted to learn about this. But not only that, but he will basically help anyone that doesn't understand something. So I specifically noticed last week we had a test coming up, and several students in the class had told me they would come see me for review the day before the test. And nobody showed up, and I was really panicked. And the next day they came to take the test, and I said, why didn't you guys come after school? And they all said, oh, we saw Evan instead. So he helped them review for the test, which was awesome. So hence, Evan, you're my Awk of the Week.
Well, that's awesome. Congratulations, Evan.
Congratulations.
Reminder for all winter sports uniforms. Boys basketball uniforms are due today. Wrestling uniforms are due Tuesday, February 27th, and points will be issued to all those who are late.
Thanks for watching, and have a great weekend from everyone here at Video Announcements.
Let's begin now. I woke up this morning and I said, you know, instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around through ups and downs, you know, I just said, look,
we're gonna have a good day.